Hi everyone, my name's Maya and I'm a zookeeper at the Fresno Chaffee Zoo. And I'm joining you today with a California newt. Now these guys have many different nicknames. They are also called fire-bellied newts, red-bellied newts, and that's because of this bright orange coloration that they have running all the way down the length of their body. Now that coloration actually serves a very important purpose. We like to refer to bright colors in the animal kingdom, things like yellows, oranges, and reds, as warning coloration. So what that coloration lets any predators know is, back off, I'm poisonous, and you do not want to eat me as a snack. So if a newt were to feel threatened, one adaptation that they might display is that they might actually raise their tail and their chest so that those bright orange colors are showing off to the predator, and that predator can rethink their choices. Newts have what's called a neurotoxin. So that is a toxin that affects the neuro system of the body. So if an animal were to eat a rough-skinned or a fire-bellied newt, they would likely experience different neurological symptoms like headache and potentially death. These guys are amphibians, so you'll notice I'm wearing gloves while I'm handling our rough-skinned newt friend. That is for my protection because of the neurotoxins, but it is also for his protection. Amphibians breathe through their skin and they absorb whatever is in the air around them through their skin. And so if I have any oils or chemicals on my hands, I want to make sure that those things aren't being absorbed by our newt friend and causing him to get sick. Rough-skinned newts can be found in California. They can actually be found all over, including near Fresno. If you do see these guys in the wild, it's a good idea to leave them where you find them. Amphibians can be very delicate, and they also serve an important role in our ecosystems. Most amphibians we like to refer to as indicator species. So that means they will indicate the health of the environment. Because their skin absorbs everything that they are exposed to, if the environment is unhealthy and has lots of toxins and heavy metals in it, we're probably not going to find as many amphibians in that area. If it's a healthy environment with clean water and good air, we're much more likely to find a healthy amphibian population. Thanks for joining us today, and we'll be back with lots of other great animals from the Fresno Chaffee Zoo.